Hey everyone, welcome to our third lecture, the Articles of Confederation. We often tell the story of revolution as the story of the oppressed beats the oppressor, the end. We have this underdog who has the stake stacked against them, who is up against this beast. And then our underdog beats the beast and story over, happily ever after. The real story is just beginning. If you think fighting for change is hard, the real work comes in creating the change. And that's where the pain is, the struggle. And that's exactly what happened to the United States once we won the Revolutionary War. The actual revolution isn't the war itself, but structuring the society that they envisioned. So our first attempt at a new government, our first constitution, our first attempt at democracy was the Articles of Confederation. And the Articles of Confederation was a mess. The Articles of Confederation, the original AOC, it was created by looking at a monarchy and saying, we know what we don't want. So let's completely swing in the other direction and make a central government as weak as possible. There was no president, no court, no military, no real central force of authority. It was miss after miss after miss after miss. We operated like a bunch of mini nations, all tied together. Think Europe, and for good reason too. The culture in New York is vastly different than Georgia. So each state had their own laws, money, and basically acted as a league of friendship. Also cited in the actual Articles of Confederation, the states hereby enter into a league of friendship. Here were the five main problems for the Articles of Confederation. Number one, Congress had no power to tax. In order to fund the federal government, they depended on donations. And when something is voluntary, there is significantly less done. So our government had no money. Number two, Congress has no power to enforce treaties. Even if a problem between two states or a state and a whole other nation arose, there was no way to ensure peace. Imagine Delaware going to war with France. Delaware. Number three, every state, despite size, only has one vote. On the surface, that might seem fair, but then it gives a state like New Jersey less of a say than those people in Delaware. Delaware. Number four, Congress has no power to regulate commerce. So there were different systems of trade and currency throughout all the states. There was no baseline of value, and Lord knows how the people in Delaware like to rip others off. And number five, any amendment to the AOC requires unanimous vote by states. Not a majority, but all. If any change had to happen, it needed everyone to agree. And don't even count on Delaware, always just saying no, just to say it. These five problems, the lack of regulation, all came to a breaking point when Shays' Rebellion took place in, guess, Massachusetts. Very quickly, Shays' Rebellion was a bunch of Revolutionary War veterans led by Daniel Shays, who were angry that they were not compensated for the war, and what little land they had was being taxed and taken away by Massachusetts state government. Massachusetts did the two no-nos of the political landscape today. Number one, they raised taxes. Number two, they pissed off veterans. And there was no way to stop the rebellion because there was no military. So Massachusetts had to scrap an army together as the rebellion reached the arsenal where they kept all the guns. So after this, our Congress got together and said, okay, the Articles of Confederation isn't working. Let's make something else. The importance of the AOC was it's an optimistic view of human nature saying, we don't need much regulation, we can work things out on our own. And while that idea still persists today, historically it ends with poverty, lack of resources, and ultimately rebellion. While people might be seen as good or with good intentions, to create a government based on expecting the best out of people leaves room for the darkness to grow. We needed a government able to regulate not only people, but itself. What we needed was a new constitution. And that part is coming up in our next lecture. Thank you for watching. Godspeed.